In the last video, we did till question number 6 of main question 7. Till here, we completed. Okay. Now, in question number 7, the sub question 7, 8, and 9, these three, and main question 8 and main question 9. This part we'll do it later. Okay, mostly it will get cancelled in school. If it doesn't get cancelled, we'll do it later. Okay, I'll start with question number 10 now. Okay, don't do it for homework also right now. Only do homework which questions I have explained you. Okay, we'll start with question number 10 now. Last class, last video lecture, we did rationalize the denominators. Correct? We did rationalize the denominators. Now we will continue with that. But sums will get a bit complicated now. Like the question number 10, first question. Mark question number 10 is very important. Okay? Surely there will be one sum from question number 10. Okay? The sixth question in question number 10 is not important, but the first five questions of question number 10 are very important. Okay. So, in the first question, they've given the value of x is 7 minus 4 root 3. Value of x is 7 minus 4 root 3. And we have to find, what we have to find? We have to find x plus 1 upon x. And we have to find x square plus 1 upon x square. These two things we have to find. Okay. And we have the value of x. So how to solve the question now? Here you see in the first part, we have to find x plus 1 upon x. The value of x, we know. Value of x is this. But value of 1 upon x, we don't know. So let's find the value of 1 upon x first. Okay. So I'll write here 1 upon x is equals to 1 upon, what is the value of x? 7 minus 4 root 3. So I'll write here 7 minus 4 root 3. This is 1 upon x. I'll solve this now. I'll simplify it. How to simplify? I'll rationalize the denominator here. Okay. How to rationalize the denominator? I explained you in the last video that we have to multiply the numerator and denominator by 7, 4 root 3, and the sign will be opposite sign. So I'll multiply the numerator and denominator by 7 plus 4 root 3 upon 7 plus 4 root 3. This denominator, change the sign and multiply the numerator and denominator by that number. Okay, it's very important. Now here 7 plus 4 root 3, the numerator, 1 into 7 plus 4 root 3 is nothing but 7 plus 4 root 3. In the denominator, you have 6. Okay. I have told you in the last class also that in the denominator, you will always get the formula A minus B, A plus B. Okay. Always you will have this formula A minus B, A plus B. So this is first term is A, second term is B. So what is the formula for A minus B into A plus B? Formula is it becomes A square minus B square. I hope you remember. You must by heart these formulas. Okay. So here also A minus B, A plus B. In the next step, it will become upon A square. This is A square. That means 7 square minus B is 4 root 3. So this will become B square. See, A minus B, A plus B, A minus B, A plus B becomes A square minus B square. Now let's simplify a bit further. Upon this all steps are for 1 upon x. We are finding 1 upon x. Don't forget that. Okay. 7 square is 49 minus 4 square is 16. 4 square is 16 and root 3 square. I have told you root 3 square. The root and the square will get cancelled. So you will get 3. Now Simplify it further, I'll get 1 upon x is equals to 7 plus 4 root 3 upon 49 minus 16 into 3 is 48. So the answer is 7 plus 4 root 3. 49 minus 48 is 1. So 7 plus 4 root 3 upon 1 is the answer. Even if you don't write upon 1, it is okay. The answer is 7 plus 4 root 3. So basically 1 upon x, the value of 1 upon x you found, you got as 7 plus 4 root 3. The value of x in the question was what? 7 minus 4 root 3. Now we have to find x plus 1 upon x. So let's find x plus 1 upon x. In the place of x, you write the value of x which was given in question. 7 minus 4 root 3. Okay. Plus 1 upon x, you have found the value. It was 7 plus 4 root 3. Okay. If I add both of them, you observe minus 4 root 3 and plus 4 root 3 will get cancelled. Okay. So 7 plus 7, you will get 14. So my answer for x plus 1 upon x is 14. Okay. Now I have to find x square plus 1 upon x square. What is to be found? X square plus 1 upon x square. Here, expansion chapter will help us. We did a formula in expansion chapter. What was the formula? X plus 1 upon x, the whole square, is equals to x square plus 1 upon x square plus 2. This was the formula we did. So x plus 1 upon x, value of x plus 1 upon x is 14. 14 square is equals to, we don't know the value of x square plus 1 upon x square, plus 2. See, this formula we had done in expansions. I hope you remember. Now 14 square is 196 is equals to x square plus 1 upon x square plus 2. This plus 2 will go here and get subtracted. X square. So your answer is 194. This is our final answer. Copy the question, each and every step properly. Okay. Question number 10, the second one, is again the same, exactly same question, but I'll solve it because it is something new for you and it is also very important. So I'll solve it for you. We'll do it on next page. We have to find x plus 1 upon x and we have to find x square plus 1 upon x. That is the same. We have the value of x. Again, the first step, we'll find 1 upon x. What is 1 upon x? 1 upon 9 plus 4 root 5. I'll rationalize the denominator. That means I'll multiply the numerator and denominator by 9. So this is plus sign here, so I'll take minus. 9 minus 4 root 5 upon 9 minus 4 root 5. Okay, numerator and denominator. 9 minus 4 root 5, 9 times 4 root 5. I'll make brackets here. Okay, so now 9 minus 4 root 5 into 1 will remain 9 minus 4 root 5. Upon, this is a plus b, a minus b. As usual, I've told you always in the denominator, you will have this formula a square minus b square. So here a plus b, a minus b will become a square, that means 9 square. Minus b square is 4 root 5 the whole square. Okay. So 9 minus 4 root 5 upon 9 square is 81 minus 4 root 5 square. See, 4 square. First I'll take a number square. 4 square is 16 into root 5 square. Root 5 square is 5. So this will become 9 minus 4 root 5 upon 81 minus 80 and this is nothing but 9 minus 4 root 5. Because in the denominator you will have 1. 1 doesn't have any. No need to write the denominator. So you got the value of 1 upon x. Okay. Now we have to find x plus 1 upon x. That means x, value of x given in the question is 9 plus 4 root 5. And value of 1 upon x which we found is 9 minus 4 root 5. So plus 4 root 5 minus 4 root 5 cancelled. 9 plus 9 is 18. So answer is x plus 1 upon x is 18. Now I'll use this formula from expansions. Here, in the place of x plus 1 upon x, I'll write 18. This 2 will go there and get subtracted. So you will get minus 2. 18 square. 18 square is 324. So your final answer is 322. Okay. That's it. Now in this question, they have given us the value of a as root 7 plus root 6 upon root 7 minus root 6. And the value of b is also given. Value of b is root 7 minus root 6 upon root 7 plus root 6. Okay. So how to solve this? First, I'll solve this a. Okay, first I'll solve the a. I'll simplify it. Okay, I'll rationalize the denominator for a. I'll solve it. Then I'll solve for b. And then they have said find the value of a plus b. A plus b means I'll add the answer of a and answer of b. So let's solve a first. So in a, see denominator is root 7 minus root 6. So to rationalize, I will multiply it with root 7 plus root 6 upon root 7 plus root 6. So only sign changes, number remains the same. Okay. So now we have to multiply them. Let's put brackets here for easier understanding. Okay. So now, this, if you observe, see, this is root 7 plus root 6. This is also root 7 plus root 6. Both sign are same. Both are same. The numbers are exactly same. So I can write them as root 7 plus root 6 the whole square. Because they are same. See, root 7 plus root 6, root 7 plus root 6. Upon, here I have told you in denominator always you will have the formula a square minus b square. So root 7 minus root 6 into root 7 plus root 6. This will become a square, that is root 7 square minus b square, that is root 6 square. In the numerator, when you open the bracket, you have to use the formula a plus b the whole square. A plus b the whole square is a square plus 2 AB plus B square, root 6 square. This is root 6 square. Okay. Upon root 7 square. Root 7 square is root sign will go away. Root 7 into root 7 is 7 minus root 6 square means root 6, root and square will go away. Cancel. So it will be 6. Now in the numerator, root 7 square is 7 plus 2 root 7 into root 6. Root 7 into root 6, when you multiply the numbers inside the root, the numbers will get multiplied and root sign will remain as it is. So you will get 2 root 7 into 6 is 42 plus root 6 square, the root sign will go away, 6 upon 7 minus 6 is 1. Now 7 plus 6 is 13 plus 2 root 42. This is my answer. This is the value of A. See, I have only found A till now. Now I'll do B. B is root 7 minus root 6 upon root 7 plus root 6 into, see the denominator sign is plus, so I'll multiply it with minus, so root 7 minus root 6 upon root 7 minus root 6, both are same. I'll add brackets here, is equals to, if you observe, this is both, these both brackets are same, see root 7 minus root 6 into root 7 minus root 6. If the brackets are same, this will become the whole square upon, and the denominator is always a square minus b square, so a is root 7, root 7 square minus root 6 square, okay, is equals to, here I'll use the formula a minus b the whole square, a minus b the whole square is a square minus 2ab plus b square is root 6 square, okay, upon root 7 square is 7 minus root 6 square is 6, is equals to root 7 square is 7 minus 2 root 7 into root 6 is root 42 plus root 6 square is 6 upon 1. So final answer is 7 plus 6 13 minus 2 root 42. This is the answer of B I got. Okay. Now I have got the answer of A as well as B. Now they have asked me to add A and B. We want a plus b, so the value of a was 13 plus 2 root 42 plus b is 13 minus 2 root 42, so 2 root 42 cancel, 13 plus 13 is 26. This is my answer. In the exactly same manner, we have to solve the fourth sum also. Exactly same. Okay. See, you have the question root 5 plus root 3 upon root 5 minus root 3 plus root 5 minus root 3 upon root 5 plus root 3. You have to add them. So first you solve this part, then you solve this part, and then add both the answers. Okay. So let's do this. You can even pause the video and try it yourself. Okay. And then check with my answer. Okay. I'll rationalize it with the opposite sign. So this will be root 5 plus root 3 upon root 5 plus root 3. Okay. I'm doing the first part. This first part. In the numerator, see both brackets are same. So I can write root 5 plus root 3 the whole square upon the denominator, it will be a square minus b square. So here a plus b the whole square is a square plus 2ab plus b square. Upon root 5 square is 5 minus root 3 square is 3. Here next step, root 5 square is 5 plus 2 root 5 into root 3 is root 15 plus root 3 square. Root 3 square is 3. 5 minus 3 is 2. 5 plus 3 is 8. See, 5 plus 3 is 8. We cannot add them because here 2 is with this root 15. So 5 plus 3 is 8 plus 2 root 15 upon 2. Now here we can cancel this 2, but not directly. First I have to take common here. In the numerator, from this one term and this second term, I'll take 2 common. So if I take 2 common, I'll get 4 plus 2 is gone. Root 15 is remaining. Like this, first I'll take 2 common, then this 2 and this 2 can be cancelled, and I get it as My final answer is 4 plus root 15. Okay. This was my first part answer. Now the second part. Second part is, this is the second part. 5 minus root 3 upon root 5 plus root 3. Okay. Again here, I will rationalize the denominator with opposite sign. So 5 minus root 3 upon root 5 minus root 3. These both are same. In the denominator, a square minus b square. A minus b the whole square here. It will be a square minus 2ab plus b square. In the denominator, root 5 square is 5 minus root 3 square is 3. Root 5 square is 5 minus 2. Root 5 into root 3, root 15 plus root 3 square is 3. 5 minus 3 is 2. 5 plus 3 is 8 minus 2 root 15 upon 2. Again here I will take 2 common. 8 will become 4 minus 2 gone. So what is remaining? 15 upon 2. 2 and 2 cancel. My answer is 4 minus root 15. Once I get this answer, I simplified this and I have simplified this. Basically, I have to add both this. So I'll add both the answers. First answer was 4 plus root 15 plus second answer is 4 minus root 15. 15, 15 cancel. 4 plus 4 is 8. This is my final answer. Okay. Copy the sum. Question number 4 we did, now question number 5. See, all questions are similar. Okay, all of them are same. 5th question, 7 upon 3 root 5 minus 2 plus 2 upon 3 root 5 plus 2. Now this question also, we'll solve this part first and then we'll solve this part and then we'll add answers. Okay, so here I'll solve this part first. I'll rationalize the denominator. That is the only way you can solve it. Rationalize the denominator into root 3 minus 2 is there. Root 3 plus 5, sorry, 3 root 5 minus 2 is there. So I'll see 3 root 5 plus 2 upon 3 root 5 plus 2. Sign changes. Okay, so here the 7 will get multiplied with this bracket. So see, 7 will get multiplied with first term and 7 will get multiplied with 2. So 7 into 3 is 21 root 5. 7 into plus 2 is plus 14 upon 3 root 5 minus 2. 3 root 5 plus 2 means a plus b, a minus b. So that is a square minus b square. This if I solve, I get 3 root 5 square. So 3 square is 9 into root 5 square is 5 minus 4 square is 4. And the next step here, 21 root 5 plus 14 upon 9 5s are 45. 45 minus 4. So answer is 21 root 5 plus 14 upon 41. Okay. Now I'll do the second part. Second part is 2 upon 3 root 5 plus 2. I'll rationalize this also. Okay. 3 root 5 minus 2 upon 3 root 5 minus 2. Opposite sign. Now this 2 will get multiplied with this bracket. So I'll have 2 into 3 root 5, 6 root 5 minus 2 into 2, 4 upon a plus b, a minus b. So a square minus b square. Okay. So this will be 6 root 5 minus 4 upon, and this 3 root 5 square, 3 root 5 square, 3 square is 9, root 5 square is 5, minus, same thing, same value which we will get here, na, they also will get the same value, minus 2 square is 4. So 6 root 5 minus 4 upon 9 5s are 45 minus 4. So my answer is 6 root 5 minus 4 upon 41. So this was my first answer. This was my second answer. In the end, see, question is this. I solved this part. I have solved this part. Now I have to add both. So I'll add both the answers. This is first answer, 21 root 5 plus 14 upon 41. So 21 root 5 plus 14 upon 41 plus second answer is 6 root 5 minus 4 upon 41. Now the base is same, no need to take LCM. Here 21 root 5 plus 6 root 5 will become 27 root 5. See, 21 plus 6, 27 root 5 plus 14 minus 4, 14 minus 4 is 10 upon 41. This is my final answer. Okay. See, you could have solved the sum simultaneously also. Simultaneously means this first part you solve, right, plus sign, and then solve the second part alongside. You can solve both parts together also. Okay. Or you can separately solve both parts. Doesn't matter. Both of them are correct. Okay. Now, the sixth question. Sixth question, leave it for now. Okay, leave it for now. We'll do question number 11. Okay, see, do only those questions which I am telling you now, because the chapter is lengthy. If you try to do all at once, you won't understand. You will forget few things, and most of the things will get cancelled in your class. So don't worry about that. Question number 11. The first part is root 2, 3 root 5. 4th root of 7. Write the following numbers in ascending order. Okay. Ascending order means small to big. Okay. Ascending order is like going up from small to big. Okay. So we had done question number 3 in this exercise. Compare the following search. Okay. How about it? We did 3 steps in those comparison. First, we wrote the power in fraction. Second, we took LCM of the powers. And third, we took numerator aside. Okay, if you recall, you can turn your pages and see question number 3 how we did. In the same manner, we'll do this question. Okay. Basically, we have to compare these 3 numbers and check which one is bigger and which one is smaller. Okay. We cannot directly compare it because, see, this is square root, this is cube root, this is fourth root. So, I cannot directly compare. So what I'll do, I'll write this root 2 as 2 raised to 1 upon 2. I have told you that root sign means 1 upon 2. This cube root is 5 raised to 1 upon 3. And this fourth root is 7 raised to 1 upon 4. Okay, in the power, root is 1 upon 2, cube root is 1 upon 3, fourth root is 1 upon 4. Okay, so now I'll take LCM of the powers. Okay, forget these numbers. Take LCM of the powers. So 2, 3 and 4, the LCM of 2, 3, 4 is 12. Okay, LCM is 12. So here it will be 2 raised to, if I want to bring 12 in the denominator, I'll multiply the numerator and denominator with 6. So this will become 6 upon 12. Here I'll multiply the numerator and denominator by 4. So this will become 5 raised to 4 upon 12. And here I'll multiply with 3. So this will be 3 upon 12. Now the denominators are same. This numerator I have told you, numerators we have to take it aside. Numerator ko side mein lena hai. Theek hai? If we take them aside, it will become 2 raised to 6 into 1 upon 12, 5 raised to 4 into 1 upon 12, 7 raised to 3 into 1 upon 12. Okay, 3 step I told you, 3 step to remember this method. First write, convert the root into fraction, then take LCM and then shift the numerators aside. Okay, numerator side mein lena hai basically. Theek hai? To isse kya hoga? Keep this 1 upon 12 intact. Keep this 1 upon 12 as it is. This 2 raised to 6 is what? Multiply 2 6 times. You will get the answer 64 raised to 1 upon 12. Second, 5 raised to 4. Multiply 5 4 times. You will get 625 raised to 1 upon 12. And 7 cube. 7 cube is 343 raised to 1 upon 12. Now the powers are same. I can easily compare. Which number is the smaller number? This is the smaller 64. So this is first. Then second is 343. This is second. And 625 is third. So in the end, I have to arrange the numbers in ascending order. Ascending means smallest number will come first. This number will come first. This is second and this is third. But when you write the answers, you have to use the question. Okay. So this first. First means this was root 2. So I'll write first root 2. Second is 343. What was the question here? Fourth root of 7. So I'll write fourth root of 7. And third is this. Third is cube root of 3. Sorry, 5. Sorry. This is how I arrange it in ascending orders. The smallest number first, then this, and then this one. Okay. But in the answers, you have to use this question terms to arrange them. Okay. These are answers. Copy it. Next. This was the 11th question number 1. Now the 2, the sum is easy. Sum is easier. Why? Because all roots are same. This is the question. Okay. So see, we have 4 root 3. Okay, this 4 is a number. We have 4 root 3. If you send this 4 inside the root, okay, see, this is not 4th root of 3. See, this is not like this. It is not written like this. Okay. It is 4 is outside. That means 4 is a number. If I send this number inside the root, it will become 16. Okay. See, because, see, root, if you have root 16, 16 comes out and it becomes 4. So if 4 goes in, it will become 16. Okay. Then this 2 goes inside, it will become 4. जब भी कोई नंबर रूट के बाहर से रूट के अंदर जाएगा तो उसका स्क्वायर हो जाता है. ओके okay? अगर वो बाहर आता है तो उसका रूट होता है, अंदर जाएगा तो उसका स्क्वायर होगा 4. अब ये भी रूट में है, दिस इज ऑल्सो इन रूट. सो ये 5 अलग बचा है, इसको भी रूट में लिखना पड़ेगा. तो आई कैन राइट 5 एज रूट 25, रूट 25 क्या होता है, 5 ही होता है, बट उसे रूट में लिखा सो दैट कंपेयर करना इजी हो. और लास्ट इज रूट 75. अब 16 थ्री जा इज रूट 48, 27 इंटू 4 इज रूट 108, दिस इज रूट 25, दिस इज रूट 75. नाउ ऑल द नंबर्स आर इन सेम रूट, आई कैन कंपेयर देम. असेंडिंग मीन्स दिस विल बी फर्स्ट, दिस इज सेकेंड, दिस इज थर्ड, दिस इज फोर्थ. तो अगर ये फर्स्ट है तो इसका क्वेश्चन क्या था, 5, तो पहले आएगा 5. सेकेंड ये है, क्वेश्चन क्या था, 4 रूट 3. थर्ड ये है, क्वेश्चन क्या था, रूट 75. एंड फोर्थ क्या था, 2 रूट 27. ओके, क्वेश्चन नंबर 11 इज डन. क्वेश्चन नंबर 12 अगेन सेम, एग्जैक्टली सेम, जस्ट यू हैव टू राइट इन डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर. योर डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर मीन्स बड़े से छोटा, कमिंग डाउन. ओके, तो अगेन कंपैरिजन वाला पार्ट रिमेन सेम. सो योर द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज 5 रूट 2, 8 अपॉन रूट 2, रूट 98 एंड 2 रूट 18. ओके, दिस 5 goes inside the root, it will become 25. 2 into 25, bracket. This 8 upon root 2, see how to solve this 8 upon root 2. If I want to rationalize, I'll rationalize this, I'll make it a simple number. Okay, so how do I do it? To rationalize the denominator, I'll multiply this fraction with root 2 in the numerator and denominator. See, if I want to rationalize this denominator, root 2, I'll multiply it with root 2 and root 2 in the numerator and denominator. Okay, because there is only one term. If there were two terms, like if I had x minus root 2, to hum x plus root 2, x plus root 2 se karte upar niche. Nahi, yahan pe to ek hi term hai. To wahi same terms se hum upar niche multiply karenge. Root 98 ko aise hi rakhte and root 18, ये 2 जब अंदर जाएगा तो वो 4 बन जाएगा, करेक्ट. 2 इंटू 25 इज रूट 50. यहाँ पे 8 रूट 2, रूट 2 इंटू रूट 2 इज 2, रूट 98 एंड दिस 18 इंटू 4 इज रूट 72. यहाँ पे 2 वन जा, 2 फोर जा, तो क्या मिला, 4 रूट 2 मिला. अब इस 4 रूट 2 का, ये 4 जब रूट के अंदर जाएगा, सी ये 4 रूट 2 है, ये 4 जब रूट के अंदर जाएगा तो 16 बन जाएगा. दिस विल बी रूट 4 अंदर गया तो 16 बन गया, रूट 98 एंड रूट 72. सो रूट 50, रूट 32, रूट 98, रूट 72. अब ये मुझे मिल गया सब कुछ इन द फॉर्म ऑफ रूट. Now I have to arrange this in descending order. Descending means biggest number will come first. So biggest is 98 first, 72 second, this is third, and this is fourth. So the biggest number is root 98. Root 98, question was also root 98. I'll write first root 98. Second is root 72. Root 72 means 2 root 18. 2 root 18. Third is root 50. Root 50 was 5 root 2. And fourth is root 32. Root 32 was 8 upon root 2. Okay. This 8 upon, this part was important. Okay, this part was new also for you. Whenever you have a single number, na, agar ek single root hai, samjho root 6 hota, to upar niche root 6 se multiply karte. Root 10 hota, to upar niche root 10 se multiply karte. Theek hai? So that wo root root cancel hoke normal number ban jaye. Ye rationalize ho gaya. Okay. Copy this question. Last one is question number 12, second one. Pause the video and copy it. Here again we have cube root, square root and fourth root. अलग अलग root आ गया. अगर अलग अलग root आता है तो we'll have to use that comparison वाला formula. Where cube root means 1 upon 3 होता है, square root means 1 upon 2 and fourth root means 1 upon 4. अब एलसीएम लेंगे, 3, 2, 4, अगेन एलसीएम विल बी 12, सो ये होगा ऊपर नीचे 4 से मल्टीप्लाई, ये होगा 6 से और ये होगा 3 से. ओके तो ऊपर नीचे 4 से मल्टीप्लाई हुआ मीन्स 4/12, दिस विल बिकम 6/12 एंड दिस इज 3/12. अब न्यूमरेटर को साइड में लेंगे सो 4 × 1/12, 6 × 1/12, 3 × 1/12. ओके 5 raised to 4, 5 raised to 4 इज 625 raised to 1/12. 3 raised to 6, 6 times मल्टीप्लाई करना पड़ेगा 3 को. ओके सो वो होगा 729. यू कैलकुलेट इट. ओके इज नॉट ईजी. लाइक सी 3 × 3 × 3 करोगे तो 27 मिलेगा, और 3 × 3 × 3 करोगे तो 27. 6 बार 3 मल्टीप्लाई करना है, सो 27 × 27 विल गिव यू 729 raised to 1/12. And 8 raised to 3, 8 cube is 5 × 12 raised to 1/12. अब इसे डिसेंडिंग में अरेंज करना है, मीन्स बड़ा नंबर पहले आएगा देन छोटा नंबर लास्ट में आएगा. सो बड़ा नंबर इज दिस, बिगेस्ट नंबर वॉज √3. ओके सो बिगेस्ट नंबर इज √3, सेकेंड बिगेस्ट इज दिस, दिस वॉज √5 एंड थर्ड इज √4. This is my answer arranged in descending order. Okay? So we have completed the chapter. For now, you have to practice these sums only. The few sums which you have left, we'll do it later. We'll start with the new chapter in next video. Thank you.